In this session, we will use MicroPython to perform UART communication with the Raspberry Pi Pico. So insert the module. For reference, the pins we will use here are Y9 and Y10, where Y10 is RX and Y9 is TX. So first, carefully establish a connection between both ends with jumper cables that have female connectors. For communication purposes, you need to connect one ground wire securely to one side of your setup. This is essentially a wire pin configuration I have set up like this. Now, as you can clearly see here in front of us, this is indeed what we call a UART2 TTL converter device. I have connected the black colored wire firmly to GND terminal point. Additionally, as previously mentioned earlier on in our discussion today, Y10 serves as RX, which corresponds directly with being identified by its white color coding. The white colored wiring should therefore be connected appropriately over onto TX, since Y10 functions primarily under RX mode. Furthermore, then proceed accordingly by connecting Y9, which acts functionally under TX, to RX located strategically upon opposite side connections within your system architecture framework. Please ensure everything gets connected precisely in exactly this particular manner. Last time, we opened the code. Now, let's delete this and then write from machine import UART. Next, we will set UART to UART1. I will set the baud rate to 11.5200. And then, what write, followed by hello device mult. For reference, as mentioned earlier, TX is Y9 and RX is Y12. Next, while if new at any, actually checks if there is indeed any data, indeed coming from the opposite side. If there is data, it will enter here. Let's try executing the if statement with text. New at red, 128 bytes, print, text. I have connected it now, and I will run the program. If I press it, you can see that it is connected here. I intentionally connected it to the Arduino serial monitor, and as soon as it connects, it displays hello device mart. Now, I will input a message like nice to, and you can see what I entered here. In this case here, at pins 9 and 10, the Raspberry Pi Pico reads 128 bytes from the other side and prints it to the console. Once again, in this particular manner, the output will be generated and displayed right here in this location, ensuring that the process is clear and understandable for everyone involved. In this way, you can control the UART of the Raspberry Pi Pico using MicroPython. In this session, we tried controlling the UART of the Raspberry Pi Pico using MicroPython. I will see you next time with different content.